As you can tell by the title, today we'll be decluttering my pressed and loose face powders. I'm sorry if you could hear my dog barking in the background. We are currently having a thunderstorm, so you could probably hear him screaming. But today I just wanted to declutter my pressed and loose face powders. So I think I'm gonna tackle the pressed side first because I think that's the one I have the least amount of. So I'm just gonna start by grabbing what I know I'm gonna keep. The first thing I'm gonna keep is my all-nighter pressed powder, and this is my everyday powder. So I've been trying to work on this for a while. I don't know, I feel like I've got to be ready to hit pan sometime soon because I do use this powder every single day. I just don't know why it's not, like, it's not going down. So the powder does last forever, I can say. But for some reason, I feel like this powder has gotten a little bit darker since I've purchased it, but it's not really noticeable on the face. So I'm definitely gonna keep this one for sure. The next powder I know I'm gonna keep is this Studio Care Blend MAC Pressed Powder. And I am pretty much almost done with this powder, as you guys can tell. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna keep this to use it up, and then you guys will probably see this in a product empties. I'm in the shade Medium Plus. The next powder I know I'm gonna keep for sure is the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder, and I'm in the shade Medium, and that's the only thing that I have a problem with. This powder is so light, I do not think I should be considered medium, but I know Charlotte Tilbury might have come out with a couple more shades, I'm not sure. But yeah, I'm definitely gonna keep this one for sure. I love this powder. So now that it comes to these powders, I'm not really sure what I want to keep. I think I want to keep this one right here. This is the Peach Blur Powder by Too Faced. And it wasn't until recently that I started using it. I do like it, but sometimes the peachiness of it kind of throws me off. It's not as noticeable on the face. But I do think I'm going to keep this one. First powder that I know I'm gonna declutter is this Maybelline Super Stay Powder. This is in the shade Natural Beige, but I don't use it, and I don't know. I just don't think I need this powder, so I'm gonna get rid of this. The next powder I think I'm gonna get rid of is this MAC Medium Plus Powder, but this is the Mineralized Skin Finish, and I remember using this, and it was like super chalky and powdery for me, and I wasn't a fan of it, so I think I'm just gonna pass this one along. This is a powder by the MLM called Arbonne. My old roommate actually sent this in the mail for me for my birthday because I think like her mom sells Arbonne, so I kind of want to test it out. I don't really like MLMs, but just because my friend sent it to me in the mail, I'll try to test it out, see if I like it, and then I don't know. What do you guys think about MLMs? Like, I'm not a big fan, but I will definitely give it a shot, and it is a mattifying powder. This right here is the Too Faced Banana Cream Setting Powder, and I used to hear Andrea Montigliano like rave about this. But I have not even used it yet. So I think I'm gonna keep it and see if I can test it out and see if I can get it to work, see if I like it. If not, I'll pass it along. Sorry about my dog. And then the last powder I do wanna try. I've heard good things about the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye line, and this is just a sample of a powder, but I thought it was a decent sized powder because I feel like I could get use out of that. So I'm definitely just gonna keep this and test it out. So I did not do well in my powder section. Now we're gonna move on to our loose powders over here. The first one I see is this Makeup Revolution Luxury Baking Banana Powder. This is in the shade Lace. I'm just gonna pass this along. I don't really support Makeup Revolution anymore, and I don't buy their products. So I'm just gonna pass this one along. The next thing we have is this Fenty Beauty Powder, and this is in the shade Butter. I really like this powder, but the thing is the packaging is just so messy, but I'm definitely gonna keep this for sure. I really do like it. Next loose powder that I have is this Maybelline Fit Me Powder in the shade Fair Light, and it looks like I've gotten a decent amount of use out of it. It looks like I've done more than halfway. I haven't used it in a while. I'm interested to see if I still like it, so I might just hold on to this and see if I still like it. The next powder I have is this translucent mix and medium. Again, I heard Andrea Montigliano talk about this powder, so I think I'm going to keep this one and test it out. I know they discontinued it, but I really do want to try it out still. The next powder is this Revlon Candid Photo Ready Pollution Powder, Anti-Pollution Powder, and honestly, I don't really remember using it, so I'm just going to pass this along so someone else could get more use out of it. The next powder is this Shape Tape Setting Powder by Tarte, and honestly, the packaging is really weird. Do you see how there's like a net sifter in there? It gets super messy, and I think I'm just gonna pass this along. I tried using it a couple times, but yeah, no, I think I'm just gonna pass this along so someone else could get use out of this. See, this is what I mean by it gets really messy. The next powder that I have here is the Too Faced Peach Perfect Powder. I also have a travel size of it as well. I used to be obsessed with this powder, and I think for travel, this would be good, so I'm definitely going to keep this powder. So I'm just gonna put the mini one over here, and then I'll put this one right here. The next powder that I have is this Wet n Wild Photo Focus Translucent Loose Setting Powder, and I really do enjoy it. I'm about halfway done with this, and it does come with a lot of product, so I definitely do recommend this for an affordable option. The next thing I have is the Translucent Extra Coverage by Coty Aerospun, and I know a lot of people said that if you want to get one that works well, to get the translucent extra coverage, but I have yet to try this yet. So I might keep this just to test it out, but if I really don't like it, I'm gonna declutter it. I'm having such a hard time getting rid of powders because I do have oily skin and I do like keeping my powders. I don't know. The next powder I have is by Bare Minerals, and this is the Original Mineral Veil, and my mom actually, she's obsessed with these, and honestly, I might just give this one to her because I don't see myself using it, so I'll definitely pass this one along. So this is my Cover FX Loose Setting Powder. This is actually a new one. This is in Translucent Light. I finished up another one that was this size, and I couldn't get myself to commit to buying the full size, even though I did use it up, because I do have a bunch of full size powders. So I ended up purchasing the small one, and I'm definitely going to keep that one for sure. The next powder I actually just purchased, this is the Collab Powder in the shade Porcelain/Ivory. Usually I just use the translucent shade, but I ran out of it, and they were sold out when I went to Sally's. So I decided just to pick up this shade, and I've been using it every single day. This is probably my all-time favorite powder, besides the one that I'm going to mention next. So I'm definitely going to keep this one for sure. The next powder I have is by La Mer, and this is their The Powder. And this powder is honestly amazing. This is just their loose powder, and it's just translucent, but this is so weighted. It is so heavy, and it comes with a decent amount of product in here. Let me show you. I actually dropped this powder, and about half of the product ended up all over the ground, so I was really sad about that, but I do enjoy this powder so, so much. It's such a good powder, but it's so expensive. I love La Mer. It's so good, so I'm definitely keeping this one for sure. And then the last loose powder I have is by Laura Mercier, and mine is so used. It's so gross. I have used up way more than half of this powder, so I'm definitely just gonna keep this and use it up. I'm gonna be honest, I'm not gonna repurchase it when I run out, because I would prefer something like my Collab powder over the Laura Mercier, or like the Cover FX over the Laura Mercier, but I'm just gonna use this up, and that's all. So I just looked over onto my desk and realized that I have another powder. So this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills powder in the shade Vanilla. I recently purchased this, and I have yet to use it, so obviously I'm gonna keep this. I just don't know where to store this because it's so big and the powder is so clunky, but I'm definitely going to keep this then. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep this. So I'm gonna throw this in my everyday makeup drawer along with the collab powder and see if I can get more use out of that powder. And this, I don't know, this does not fit, but I'm trying to make it fit somewhere. But yeah, that's what we'll do. So in the end, I'm keeping 20 powders and I'm getting rid of 5. Unfortunately, I didn't do well this time, but I do try to declutter powders as I go, but I'm excited to just use the things that I like using. Thank you for everyone who has been watching and supporting my declutter series. The only question that I have is, how often should I do declutter series? Like, I know some people do every month and some people do once a year. I